is moving on to the next bout of the evening. And this one is a real battle of undefeated K.O. Ortiz. This is a national light heavyweight contest. And it's time to bring out the boxers to make their ring walk. First off, to fight out of the blue corner. Ladies and gentlemen, help me make welcome Leko Muibi.
Oh, I bet that you're not in love. Oh, my lavish. Don't be lavish. Bob, be lavish. I broke it to show you what you can do. I'm a lavish. Gotta be lavish. Shadow, what you can lavish. Oh, quality. Oh, well, oh, spend it lavish. 100% lavish. Sunday, I'm gonna be lavish. Oh, you go, oh, kilo. Oh, what you lavish. Oh, yeah, fuck your money. I want it. One calling, one wax here, assignment, what you do? Aha, she shaking it, oh what they did, my she did it. Into that day, multi-sari, oh what? Oh shabra-bra, oh no one lane, oh my bola, oh pegani, oh shabra-bra.
And it's opening to fight out of the red corner, please help me make welcome Abdul Rashid Idowu.
I like Genevieve, I thought that she's so sweet. And now you worry, cause she knows the drink I read. It's not about you, know, you cannot break me though. I want to have them all, I know it's wrong with the truth. You that's not just an Oliver.
Thank you very much. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Let's introduce the judges scoring this bout at the bell. And the judges are Tayo Olaifa, Constance Chinagoron, and Sheyi George. The referee for the bout is Segun Adesanya. And now introducing the fighters, first fighting out of the blue corner. He comes in weighing 79.5 kilograms. Has a career record of 8 fights, 8 wins. All 8 wins coming by way of knockouts. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the undefeated fighter. He's known as the Engine, Leko Muibi. And his opponent across the ring in blue and white trunks comes in with a career fighting, weighing at 78.6 kilograms, with a career record of 4 fights, 4 wins, all 4 wins coming by way of knockouts. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a battle of undefeated knockout artists, given to you, the Abdul Rashid, ID Buster, Idowu. The referee now with his instructions to the boxers.
I am Adesun Olusegun, the center referee for this bout. Obey my commands at all times. Any foul committed will be duly penalized. Yes, sir. The chief seconds has the right to throw in the towel if any of you is in danger. Touch gloves and have a great fight.
This light heavyweight clash goes for 8 rounds of boxing.
Here we go again. It's time to give you the best of boxing. The 8th bout of the night. And it promises so much explosive contest here. The Engine up against ID Buster. Who's going to get the job done, Jonita?
Lekan Muibi is a very, very, very tough boxer. I've seen him box a couple of times. I've not really seen Abdulrasheed do box, but I think it's going to be a proper contest between these both boxers. And it's a national light heavyweight challenge, so I expect to see more fireworks from both of them.
We know Muibi, the man called the Engine. If you look at his build, then you can understand why he's called the Engine. A lot of people say he's so relentless. He doesn't even stop. And that's the reason why he's got 8 fights, 8 knockouts. Absolutely remarkable achievement. But he's fighting against another boxer who's got a fantastic reputation as well. He may not know him too well because he's not fighting out of Lagos. You talk about Abdulrasheed Idowu, popularly called ID Buster. Buster probably liking himself to James Buster Douglas. Whether or not he's on the same level is another thing. But what we are sure of, it's going to be an explosive fight.
Of course, we expect a very explosive bout here tonight at this Indus Sports of the National Stadium Slow. Lekan Muibi, the Engine, versus Abdulrasheed Idowu. Keep your fingers locked as we expect firecrackers from both boxers from this arena tonight. Good body move there by Engine. While both boxers are busy sizing themselves up, the ring is electrified, the crowd is ecstatic, the vuvuzelas are sounding. Everybody's waiting to see some action from both boxers.
Now you see power play between two boxers trying to be the domineering boxer. At first it was Abdulrasheed who was the chaser. And now gradually Muibi is trying to turn the table around to become the aggressor. But that's what he loves to do most times. But he started this one out being the defensive boxer. But let's see whether he can change things.
I don't think the referee
will like that, but
yeah, let's see how it's going to be as the fight proceeds.
It does look like Abdulrasheed ID Buster is trying to, you know, intimidate Muibi just before Muibi can start anything going.
Yes.
He wants to let him know that I'm the king of this ring today and I'm dominating it.
I think Rashid Dowa has a longer reach than Lokoti, and I'm seeing Lokoti getting rocked for the first time in this.
And Lekan trying to go into the kind of mode he likes
inside,
to
yes.
Fight on the inside. And there you see him again trying to do that.
Good body head, good head movement and all that. Lekan Muibi, the Engine, taking his time to study his man before he unleashes his potentials on this man. An ID boxer, Buster, is not taking it lightly. I think he has a longer reach than Lokoti. And good uppercut there coming from the Engine.
Mutual respect for themselves, these two boxers. The Engine knows that he's up against a very, very, very a lovely one there coming from the Engine.
End of the round one, ladies and gentlemen. We've not seen nothing yet. The both boxers are trying to size each other up before they go into something more spectacular. We are still moving on to the second round. And it is 8 rounds of national lightweight challenge fight between Lekan Muibi and Rashid Idowu. We're in the round of two.
Now Leko tries to do what he knows how to do best. He's beginning to use a lot of his head movement. He wants to catch his opponent with those very little punches. And he's catching his opponent, I must say, with those explosive punches.
What an explosive round. Loco T is coming out with his firepower. Trying to tell this man that, hey man, they call me the engine, but not just for this reason. I'm Twin and Engine, and I can do some damage to you. That's
Engine. And I must say, ID Buster is also giving it toe-to-toe, standing right with him there. But I do not see the reason.
Toe-to-toe with the Engine, he is a mauler. He's going to maul you, eat you up. You can see, that's a slip.
Lovely one coming from ID Boxer, but doesn't look to have rattled the Engine. Engine keeps going forward, and that's the exact position he loves to be in. And he's been connected. He's done a great job so far, so good in this second round. And he catches him again with another one. Look at the way he's dancing out of those punches.
Head movement, they're coming from the Engine. This the Engine, look at the, who does he remind you of?
Mike Tyson,
indeed, like Iron Mike Tyson. The what movement you? And everything. Wow, very fearless, very tough on the ring, and knows what to do.
Oh, fantastic combination there, and another one again. But ID Buster giving it back to him as well. And he catches him again with that left hook. But ID Buster will not have any of it. Keeping his man on the ropes. Trying to use his size advantage. But it's not bothering at all for Leko, who ducks that again. Ducks another one. And then catches him. Referee almost tried to stop it there. Right, but referee. I thought that the referee should have allowed that fight to go on there, because Leko, who was actually hit with a rabbit punch, was actually on the ascendancy, and he had his man where he wanted him. Lovely uppercut there coming from the Engine, but the Buster fighting back as well. Good combination coming from the Buster. These two guys are giving us the best of boxing, standing toe to toe with one another. Body punches, uppercut. Still, Buster standing strong, gets caught again and catches him back as well. Lovely two left to right combination coming from the Buster. Oh, good one, left hook there. Oh, a third one as well. Oh, another big one there. And Leko keeps catching his opponent. Buster needs to watch out. He can't continue to get these punches flush in the head. Another lovely one. He connects again. Catches Leko again. And it's just connected. Oh, fantastic. Left and right combination coming from the Engine.
And we have come to the end of this round. The Engine showing some firepower there, while Rashid Idowu, ID Buster, is taking the heat, moving the heads and making sure this round goes his way. But the Engine is making sure everything falls in its own way. Ladies and gentlemen, we are in the third round of this spectacular bout between Leko Muibi and Abdul Rashid Idowu. In case you are just joining us, the Engine is on velvet trunks, black trunks with brown trims, while Idowu Buster is on blue trunks with white trims. Ladies and gentlemen, this bout is sanctioned by the Nigerian Boxing Board of Control, and we are live here at the Indoor Sports Hall of the National Stadium, Sierra Lagos State, Nigeria. It's the last boxing promotion, and it's Battle of the Ages, Season 3. We're back in the round of 3. Over to you, Nehemiah, this way.
Now the Engine I don't know, but the body language seems a bit, you know, tired. I would expect him to try in the early minutes of this round, conserve his energy, because he threw quite a lot of punches during that period. You can see there from that punch, he almost got himself in trouble. But this man, the Buster, is not even relenting at all. You see him throwing his own back, but he... Referee, what's the referee thinking about? The Buster is literally resting all his weight on top of his opponent. And
it's a way to weigh him down. It's a skill.
Yeah, but it shouldn't be allowed. It shouldn't be allowed when you're using the whole of your body to rest on your opponent when you should be punching.
Powerful body shots coming from the engine. He's leaving us to the ground. He's a danger man.
Some good combination.
Reminds me of Mike Tyson.
And Buster trying to hold on. You can see Buster there. Using his size, which, like you said, you can use it at... If you use it and you get away with it, it's all good.
Yeah, yeah.
But I expect the referee to be more strict about it and say, box.
Yes.
If you want to clinch. But do not
arrest
and smother your opponent.
Yes. Good body.
He goes to those body again and he tries to catch him in the face. And it's connected again. This is real war right here.
Absolutely.
Both of them, you can see, really knackered. It is who has it in his tank to finish this up. And that's really not... That's not allowed. You can't keep somebody's head under your arm and then you keep punching on the other side. And that's where referee Adesanya has given him another warning. He does that again, he might be deducted points.
Good one coming from the engine.
Oh, Mao! Two big punches from the engine there.
Boxes are trading punches, both of them. We can see the power behind those punches.
Massive ones there coming from the...
Good one.
And that's it. What does he do? Can Engine finish this off?
I don't think so. Idewu has lots of stamina.
He does, but he's using his size a lot to smother his opponent.
Who's more bigger, Idewu or...
You have to consider his height as well. It's not just about that. Oh, massive left-right combination again. Can he finish it?
Diving punch there.
He's also tired himself as well.
Yes. That's how boxing is. When you throw so much punches, you end up wearing out.
Yeah. Especially when you're fighting against a very durable boxer like Idy Buster is.
Another massive left coming from the engine.
Oh, he needs to watch it there. Idy doing exactly what we talked about. You know, using his body to try and pin him down on the ropes. Oh, Engie catches him. Massive stuff from these two
beautiful
boxers right here.
Beautiful, very beautiful show of boxing there by both boxers. Ladies and gentlemen, we've ended the round of three and we are moving on to the fourth round. And this bout is between Lekan Muibi and Abdulrasheed Idewu as a national light heavyweight champion challenge fight. Light heavyweight challenge fight between these two boxers. And we are live here at the Indoor Sports Hall. We are moving on to the fourth round. We're expecting to see some spectacular boxing from both boxers.
Yes, yeah, spectacular, but I expect it to be in flashes. I've seen that. It takes a whole lot for Engine to throw four combinations from time to time. So when he does that, and he still finds out that his opponent is still standing, he tends to lose steam. So he needs to be careful the way he carries out this fight. He needs to ensure that he conserves his energy, comes out strong every now and then.
If we can see the replay, we can see the damage both of them are doing to their bodies.
Yeah.
Body shots, hooks.
But Buster has proven that he's a durable boxer as well.
I can see that.
But I think he's tiring out. If you look at his footsteps while he's going into the fight again in round four, it says a lot. This is where I expect the engine to be a bit more tactical. Don't throw punches when you don't need to throw them. He started again and he almost caught his opponent there.
And this is the first time the engine is going beyond two rounds. He's a knockout machine. He does his work under two rounds and it's done. So for him to go four rounds now, let's see how good he can be.
So let's see whether this is a good strategy on the part of Idy Buster. Because you would expect Idy Buster to start growing into this fight more and more.
Yes.
Oh, Massive. Two jabs there.
Massive one by both boxers. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Lagos State, Nigeria. Where boxing lives, where boxing resides, where boxing will survive. And we are still at
He does that head movement once again. Tries to set up his opponent.
A good one coming.
But you know what? He's really done a great job with his head movement. Keeps ducking those heavy punches coming from ID Buster. And he catches ID Buster there. But now it does look like he's the one trying to clinch this time around. Could be as a result of exhaustion.
Yes, yes. I think Muibi has not gone beyond two rounds before in his career. And a lot is telling on him right now.
Absolutely. This is uncharted territory for him.
Yeah, he has never been on this tough before. Idowu is really giving him a run for his money. Nobody expects this bout to be like this.
And Idowu catches him there.
Good
and he
one.
Catches Idowu as well.
Put
he catches Idowu as well. Oh, and another big punch there. But then Idowu, once again, shoves him back into the corner. And then, Idowu needs to watch it.
Yes.
He needs to watch it. He can't continue on this trend. If he continues on this trend, the referee could go ahead and deduct his point.
Good one coming. And he's going for the kill now.
Olefa catches him once again. Almost knocking Heidi and the cameraman out of the ring.
Just one punch. And the two men will go down.
Oh, massive one again.
The fans are really, really excited. Chanting the name of Logoti, chanting the name of ID, of Idowu Buster. They don't really know who to support right now because both boxers are really giving their best. And it's the end of the round, ladies and gentlemen. We are in the fifth round. As the fourth round goes the way of either boxers, nobody knows, but we're in the fifth round already.
So this is a massive challenge for Loco T, talking about the engine, yes. Lekan Muibi. Janita said earlier, it's a massive test for him. He's never gone beyond two rounds in all his eight bouts. Quick knockout, he's out of the ring.
Yeah.
But this man, all the way from the ancient city of Ibadan, or your state, talking about ID, Abdul Rashid, ID Buster, you know, giving Loco T a good run for his money.
Indeed.
I think so far so good. I would say, the engine has taken probably four out of the five rounds we have seen so far, or three out of five. But we still got three more rounds or four more rounds starting from this one to go. Can he conserve his energy and try and save it to when he can actually, you know, release a flurry of punches that can take out his opponent?
Yeah. Let's hope something happens as the fight proceeds.
And the referee calls a break. I think it's the tape. Calls for a timeout. I think it's the tape on the gloves for ID Buster. He's out. It's an absolutely amazing punch.
He's out. Amazing punch from Togo Loco T. He's out. Idowu is out, ladies and gentlemen. A massive punch in the beginning of the round. He's out. He's done and out. Loco T, a danger man.
Where did that come from?
I didn't see it happen.
That punch came from nowhere.
From nowhere.
Lights out!
Rocket
right
punch.
Here!
Lights out! It's a miracle. It's magical. It's a miracle. It's magical. It's boxing.
What a fight! What
What a fight.
Absolutely. Magnificent.
What a fight.
Lightning quick.
What a fight.
I don't know what else to use to describe.
What a fight.
Where did that come from?
What a fight. What a fight. One fight.
So many punch that Ali Buster is being treated at the edge of his corner.
1 second. What a fight.
We gotta see that again. We gotta see that again.
We gotta see that again. And the dancers are coming in. Wow.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
We have to see that again.
We have to see that replay again.
That is a promo. That is a promo knockout.
It is a promo knockout indeed. The
end
surprises his man, does his man out, gives him a powerful, powerful punch that sends him to his canvas and he's never up, he's out, he's done, he's dusted.
Done and dusted. Absolutely done and dusted. When you talk about light out,
ladies and gentlemen,
it's called, it's what we call Sefini, it's what we call finito. Indeed, a crazy way to end. There's a boxing matchup.
Ladies and gentlemen, at exactly 1 minute and 35 seconds of the very fifth round, round number 5, we have your winner by knockout, Leko the Engine Mui.
It deserves to win. It deserves to win.
Oh, kudos has to go to Ali Buster.
Thank you very much.
Absolutely good account. And the knockout continues. 9-9. Massive result for that one.
Thank you very much.
I'm